The following film has been rated R for arson. What's arson, you ask? It's when you take awesome and set it on fire.
La siguiente película ha sido clasificada R por arson. Si te estás preguntando qué es arson, es cuando tomas la palabra awesome y la prendes en fuego.
The name's Shades, Captain Shades. My friends call me Captain. My enemies call me Oh Shit. Some people ask me, Captain, have you always been such a badass? The answer to that question is simultaneously simple and extremely complex. Actually, it's just complex, but come on. How often do you get a chance to use the word simultaneously in a sentence? Simultaneously, never.
Well, about the time my daddy left to fight the big war,
to answer the question, I used to be like this here cigarette. I was fragile, created to self-destruct, and life was sucking me to ashes before flicking my remains on the sidewalk. Now, I'm on the other side. Few people think of smokers as badass, but think about it. Of all the people you know, which ones are slowly committing suicide over the course of decades while simultaneously chipping away at the ozone? Fuck the earth. They should save the cigarettes. They say smoking kills. Well, so do I. That means together, we shall become more powerful than ever. But you gotta be careful out there. Pigs, man. More pigs out there than at Babe's family reunion. Some are just in it for the badge. Some for the drug seizures. And some just want to get famous. But here's the thing with the pigs in this town. These pigs, they don't fuck around. If they think you're even slightly out of line, they'll nail you so bad you think Jesus Christ died of a paper cut.
That's our intro music.
No, it's not. The first lines of our intro music should not be gentle leaves.
Well, the first part sounds fine.
Can we leave it at that then? Can we just have the first part play and then the plot can start moving forward before the rest?
Actually, I have a better idea. How about the guy who's supposed to register for intro music by April 3rd actually remember, for a change, to actually go to register before all the good songs are taken?
Well, you're the one that picked it, so...
I wanted the Rolling Stones. Do you know how many songs I had to choose from? Like 12. And half of those were either leftover stock music from Extreme Maker Home Edition, and the other half were just gay-ass songs from the Beatles.
So it's either the Beatles, schmaltzy piano music, or this.
Oh yeah, tell you something.
Yeah, you're right.
Just snap loose. like a busted rubber band. But this rubber band wasn't holding something in place, it was holding something out of place. My metamorphosis from the cigarette to the smoker had begun. Dude, WTF, man!
Shut up!
Oh, we got a 5-5 on 302 and over, out.
Roger, roger.
Welcome to Security Level 5, prison, state, federal dungeon, local jail, county, maximum security, Treadway Penitentiary, a.k.a. the Cinder Block. Cinder for short, Cindy by her friends. At that moment, I knew I was screwed. My trial took place during the ride. My sentence starts today and ends once every Catholic priest surrenders his Peter Pan DVD. Whatever these pigs wanted, they weren't getting. Any minute now, they're going to bust through that door and beg for information. Beg. And no matter how strong, how tough, how ferocious these guys pretend to be, when it comes down to it, they're just hobos begging. And you know what? If I had a quarter for every time a hobo begged me for change, I'd still say no.
What do you think?
Piece of cake. It could be easier to crack than Liberty Bell.
We actually have no idea how difficult that was. It could have taken years for all we
know. Good cop, bad cop. 2 seconds. You take point. Over, out. Hooah!
Damn it.
Who do you work for, motherfucker?
Stop talking, you son of a bitch!
What was that?
You said good cop, bad...
I know, but I said take point.
What the hell does that mean?
I'm the bad cop, you...
No, no, man, I was good cop last time, it's no fun.
Oh, for God's
sake. I don't get to smoke, swear, or abuse a suspect. Plus, due to my larger size, I'm more physically intimidating, thus the suspect will answer more questions to avoid being obliterated by my wrath.
Physically intimidating? You look like Gollum on coke. With hair.
Thank you, and that's not intimidating to you?
I'm sure they've got ways of making me talk. Of course, I was in Nam, Golf Bay, and six other skirmishes that you pansy-ass civvies couldn't even dream of. Ways of making me talk. Shit, I've got ways of making men act out the complete works of Shakespeare.
Are you aware of your rights, punk?
Man, I know more directions than MapQuest.
It's okay, sir. Don't let this large, skinny man scare you. You have the right to answer all questions honestly and with as little hesitation as possible, no matter what this loose cannon may tell you.
Hey, asshole, don't tell him that. Now he knows he can answer all my questions promptly and without undue wear and tear.
Aw, shucks.
Now, how many smokers are there? Is there an underground ring? Is there an above-ground bracelet? Are you the start of a movement or the end of a standstill? Who are your superiors, your inferiors, suppliers, locations, deliveries, the whole nine fucking yards? Answer me, goddammit!
Whoa! What's with this blasphemy?
I'm the bad cop. I'm allowed to blaspheme.
I know that, and I'm the good cop, so I have to object.
Touché.
Clear?
Yep.
Carry on.
All right, tough guy. Let's see how quiet you are when we turn up the heat a little. The fuck did I...
Hey.
Hold on, I'm busy.
No, really.
Stow, will you? I'm trying to find the damn heat lamp. Works every time.
Yeah, we don't have that anymore, remember? Going green, remember?
That's it.
I know how you feel. Alone, in a new scary place, racked with guilt, and not a friend in the world, and all your accomplices, whatever their names may be, have left you. Your parents probably threw you out on the streets, right? Defend for yourself like an animal? A parentless animal? Okay. And then you turned to cigarettes, right? And they were your friends, your brothers. Those little white tubes of death slowly replace all the people who should have been in your life. All those people who should have been there for you. God knows, I know exactly what you're going through. Honest. May the Lord strike me dead if I'm lying to you. Listen, just make all this go away. These people, your smoking buddies, they don't care about you. They just want to see you fall. To them, you're nothing but a carcass to feast on. You're an episode of the Mari Show, and they don't care that you're alone, and they don't care how uninvolved you are, and how unloved you are. All they care about is whether or not you're the father. It's okay. I'm here.
It's just,
What? It's okay. Just let it go.
I don't know.
That's it. Who are they? Who are your friends?
Tom.
Tom? Tonald? Is one of them named Tonald?
Thomas.
Yes.
Thomas.
What in the blue fuck?
You wanna play hardball? We'll play hardball.
Wait, no, he was just
every about... second you don't answer, I pull out a knife.
Oh my god!
And watch the blasphemy.
He's confessing!
You're damn right he is. Who else is in your little group? Who?
Oh my god!
Ah! Your god can't help you now.
That was me, actually.
Who? I've got 19 more nails.
No!
That's it, squeal!
It's Tonald! It's Tonald, isn't it?
I want a lawyer.
I mean, you know.
Yeah, like, student project and all.
Yeah, we couldn't really find two matching guns.
Kind of cost a lot. I mean, it's due tomorrow, and...
Yeah, and... The items... We had some, but the cops, weren't very happy about them.
I mean, the Jack Daniels was pushing it, really.
It really was.
And the editing's already kind of a bitch, so...
The ending is a bitch.
Well, the editing. I mean, the ending, hopefully, is...
Oh. Well, I mean, this is the ending.
We don't want to spoil it for them, but... Is it the ending?
It's basically the ending.
They don't know, do they?
They don't know.
They're totally in our hands.
You know what I think it's time for?
Are we going to stop this?
No. Another Shade voiceover.
Thy sin, in place of doom, obscure and foul, serving youthful beauty, added grace, invincible, the devil stood and felt how awful goodness is and saw virtue in her shape, how lovely, saw and penned his soul.